Our last storyteller is Erika Moore. Dr. Erika Moore is the inaugural Rhines Rising Star Assistant Professor in the Department of Materials Science and Engineering at the University of Florida. Dr. Moore's work broadly focuses on understanding how immune cells can be leveraged to enhance tissue regeneration. Recently acknowledged as Forbes 30 Under 30 in the healthcare category, Dr. Moore is a former trustee on the Duke Board of Trustees. She has been awarded the KL2 NIH training grant through the UF Clinical and Translational Science Institute, a Space Research Initiative grant, the NSF Graduate Research Fellowship, and the Ford Foundation Fellowship. Here is Dr. Moore.
When I was younger, my father often told me I had two things working against me. I'm a woman and I'm Black. He was trying to tell me that I would encounter more obstacles and more difficulties than others who weren't Black and who weren't a woman. These obstacles, however, they really do not limit me. In fact, they inspire me to be a role model and to surpass any pejorative expectations that are set upon me. My experiences and these difficulties that I've faced have helped me and inspired me to help others do the same. For as long as I can remember, I have been fascinated by research and by education. However, I cannot recall a time when I walked into a classroom or into a lab and there weren't hushed whispers or subtle questioning of why I was present. They questioned whether or not I belonged in this space, and that seeded doubt into me, into my soul, into my spirit. I wondered, maybe I could prove to them that I belonged, but I also quickly learned that it was more important to prove it to myself, to prove that I belonged in these spaces. My first test of competence really came in my sophomore year. I took an exam in a very difficult engineering course. I was shocked to see that I had actually gotten 5 points out of 100. 5 points on a midterm that was over 30% of my grade. But you know, those 5 points, they taught me more than 100 points ever could have. They taught me what failure is. You see, failure is not failing a test. Think about how many tests you'll take. Failure is not falling. I get back up after every single misstep, every single fall. This has taught me resilience, perseverance, and what true grit is. Filled with accomplishments, I was under the impression that I had overcome any obstacles and any self-doubt that I had encountered during undergraduate studies. Little did I know what was in store for me in graduate school. If I could liken my experience in undergrad as a medium-sized fish in a medium-sized pond, getting into graduate school was like being dropped into the ocean. At Duke University, I enrolled in a PhD program in biomedical engineering. If I was successful and if I would be able to graduate, I would become one of four African-American women to graduate this program with my PhD. So here I was again, challenging myself and filled with the audacity to enroll in this incredibly challenging program. I had to ask myself, would I make it? How was I going to survive this program when so few had come before me and successfully finished? Here I was with these doubts again, again and again. It seemed like they greeted me as if I was a long-lost friend instead of the victor that I had previously thought that I was. But yet again, I exceeded the bar, as so many of my ancestors who have come before me also have done. I invented, I designed, I published, and I presented my work all over the world. I began to achieve beyond my wildest dreams, impacting biomedical research and leadership in higher education, all from the perspective of a Black woman. As I neared the end of my graduate school program, I was at a crossroad. Consulting, too big. Higher education, too many lumps. Leadership development, too small. I fought even considering a career as an academic. But one day, it dawned on me. The only way to create a space for Black women who felt similarly othered or similarly uncomfortable walking into classrooms or laboratories was to become a leader in those classrooms and in those laboratories. And so my journey continued. I signed my acceptance letter 6 months later as a tenure-track academic in engineering. I joined the rankings of the 4% of African-American women with tenure-track jobs in engineering in the United States. 4%. I found myself unsure and afraid, filled with doubt. So few had journeyed out on this path before. Even those who had made it, it seemed, were few and far between. However, I understand that I am here to continue to change the landscape of science and engineering. I know that that is not easy, and that my journey will continue to be filled with doubt. I carry this role with love and with commitment. Even having the right fit or finding the perfect size does not mean troubles cease. It means more than words can say to stand here as one, fighting for the belonging of many. These obstacles allow me to encourage, to mentor, and to support anyone who's struggling with self-doubt. Being a Black person, being a Black woman in these spaces gives me the voice to confirm our ancestors' wildest dreams. We are capable. We are excellent, and we belong.